We have already talked about character by character feeding or character by character reading and writing. But in various situations, we would want some whole string to be taken, which in turn becomes more efficient. So reading and writing strings of character from and to the file is quite easy rather than doing it with individual characters. So we'll write a program which writes the strings to the file using the fputs, file put string, like this. So this is a program which is receiving the strings from the keyboard and it will write them to the file. So this is our stdio.h. We have a file pointer, we have a character array. Now this is our imaginary file, and this we have opened in write mode. Now when if this is not we are not able to open it, we'll say okay, there is a problem, we come out. Otherwise, if everything goes fine, we'll say enter a few lines of text. So whenever a user is entering the line, we use while strelen means string length of this gets, means first we will take the s gets, means gets function we'll use, this string, this s we will use, we'll find out the string length. When it is greater than 0, that means we want something to be written by or given by the keyboard, we don't want it to be 0. So if it is there, we will put s the string into the file, and we have to specifically after that we have to put a slash n after that for fp, and then we close the fp. So this is the sample run of this program. So what is happening here is each string is terminated by hitting enter, and to terminate the execution of program, we this hit enter at the beginning of the file only. So this will create a string of zero length, as we have seen strlen we have used, which the program will recognize as exiting, means signaling the closing of the file. So we have to set a character array, which as we have seen, to receive the string. The fputs function writes the content of the array to the disk now, and this fputs does not automatically add a new line character. Slash n is not automatically added, that is why we have explicitly added, just to make it easier to read the string back from the file. This we have by ourselves added. Now we have a program that reads strings from disk file. We have already written it, assume that we have written it, and this reads strings from the file, and we want to display that on the screen from a file. So we have stdio.h, we have file pointer, this is the buffer or character array. This is the file we have opened for read, and we wanted to open it. If it is not open, we say okay, there is a problem, we come out. Otherwise, if things goes fine, we'll use fgets. Because this is 80, we go up to 79, this is exactly equal to that number only, and this is fb. So when we are using fgets, we are trying to find out when we reach the null. If one by one we are reading it, one by one strings are being read and there are being printed till the time we reach the end, that is the null, and we close the fp. So this is the sample run of the program. So this fgets takes three arguments. Please understand, it takes three arguments. The first is the address of the string which is stored, the second is the maximum length, and this argument prevent the fgets to read or overflow the array. The third argument is the file pointer, and when all the lines from the file have been read, we attempt to read one more line in which we get null and we come out. I'll show you one more time. This fgets use three parameters. S is the character, this buffer we have used, this is the size, which is this size, and fp is the file pointer. And there is some